Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. You're tuned into the NFL on EA Sports. Some serious pride on the line in this contest as these two divisional rivals take the field together for the first time this season. Almost a playoff atmosphere surrounding the game between these two bitter opponents. It's the Falcons going up against the Saints. For the call, let's send you out to the broadcast booth, where we'll join our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Larry, thank you. We are down on the bayou as you get a look inside the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in New Orleans. Tonight, we wrap up week three with a good Monday nighter here between the Atlanta Falcons and the New Orleans Saints. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden. And Charles, you look at this Saints team as they interplay. They were winners last time out, so they'll be looking, Charles, to make it two in a row.
And what I enjoyed when I watched their game tape and their victory last week is they put it together in every phase. Good offense, good defense, and some key plays on special teams. Let's see if they can get that second win in a row.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Falcons. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll run with Ingram here to begin the drive. And he'll be hit and dropped for a loss at the 5-yard line. So a look here at the key inactives, and we got this list before the game down on the field. They tell us the same thing every time, don't they? Next man up.
No excuses. Be ready to play. That's the mantra of every organization. The key is having guys on the roster who are capable of filling in and playing at a high level. That's when you know you've drafted well, scouted free agents well, and stocked your team just the way you're supposed to.
And they're going to get this one up past the 25. A nice gain of 21 yards. And they talked about how important the passing game was going to be against that defensive look. Good job there going to the air for the first down.
It's all about preparation. It's all about planning. And then it's about execution. So they put it all together in practice. Okay, this is what we think we're going to see. This is how they get to it. And then when the game comes, read it and attack it.
And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards. And it'll be second and about a yard to go for the first. Near the 45, they'll spot it at the 44. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs, and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
All right, here we go. No. Check. Patriot.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And he's got it over the middle. Fleener, a gain of 6 there on first.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Hurry up, here we go. Back down and out, Philly, here we go.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Escaping the pressure right, and he'll slide down to avoid the contact. Give him 12 yards on that one, it earns him a fresh set of downs.
Offensively, they liked their situation, so they tried to take a shot downfield, but no one was open, so it was tuck it in run time, and he picks up a first down.
On first first down. He'll drop to throw. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. That one goes for 24 yards.
This offense is in rhythm now, just accumulating first downs and moving the ball downfield.
So we played one quarter here on a Monday night. Nothing, nothing, our score. We'll head back to New Orleans after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Saints football to begin quarter number two, and they're on the move here. They've got it first and 10. Into his left, and he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Brooks Reed in there to sack him for a loss of six. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. But you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you.
And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Brandon Williams in there to drop him, and that will go into the books as the first sack of his young NFL career. And for the Falcons, 5 men in the secondary, now on third.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
It's complete to Flanner, and he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. His second touchdown on the season. And the Saints are able to cash in for six. Boy, it's nice to have that big, reliable target you can go to.
Each and every time. A lot of people see that position as a fallback. Throw it to them when all else fails. Not at all. This guy can make plays, and that's exactly what he just did.
Yeah, play here for a touchdown. Seemingly endless drive continues. So now it's first and goal. They'll look to run with Ingram. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Mark Ingram, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Saints have taken the lead. Solid job up front, really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run, end result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on the punt. And not what he was hoping for there, as this will hit in the end zone for a touchback. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here.
Trying to defend a drag route is really tough because you don't want to jump a route that's shorter or underneath as the drag route is too quickly, because oftentimes they want to run that route and then hit over the top of you for bigger yardage. So if you can chip off the timing of the receiver off the line of scrimmage so he can't actually get into the route, that's the best way to defend it. But there was no possibility of that on that play. End result, receiver won in a big way.
Play clock winding down. They'll look to throw now on first down. Flushed out right. Give them 18 on that one. And the Saints are going to get a first down.
Well, that was man coverage. So once he decides to run with the football, there's no one to account for him, and he turns it into a nice game.
They come up with one back. That's Ingram. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. It's a gain of 13 for number 13, and it gives him a first down.
And those first downs do add up. The offense keeps the ball moving downfield and keeps their defense on the bench, giving them a chance to rest.
First and goal from the five. They'll run here with Ingram. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the four. He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal.
And a nice job defensively to keep him out of the end zone. He's trying to get a second touchdown already in the first half.
They had that one earlier. Was bidding for a second. Spotted at the four. It's second and goal. This is Ingram, and he is going to lose yardage here. He lost four there, and it's third down.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
Time running out here on the play clock. They'll look to throw on third and goal. And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Larry Ridley is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. And he's been busy with his feet. He's been quite the scrambling man.
And obviously that can break down a defense, but a lot of it is just that they just get trapped with worrying about it so much that other things break down as well. You know, you break the huddle and you're not just playing what comes out at you. You're like, oh God, don't let him outside of the pocket. Don't let him beat us with his legs. And then he starts to beat you other ways.
Down. He goes underneath to Ingram, and he'll get it up here this time to the 21. Call it a 1 yard gain on the play, and that'll bring up second down. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. Now they'll throw here out of the gun. He's got his man. It's Brandon Coleman. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
All that practice time came to fruition on that play. All those timing routes that they work on through training camp, OTAs, mini camp, and just regular season, they got it done on that one. An outcut, ball was delivered, and picked up the completion.
He'll drop to throw. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football, because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
The good signal callers would never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
On third down, he'll drop to throw, and that's incomplete.
Everything about that play tells you about today's NFL offenses and what they're asking out of running backs. You can't just be a guy who can run the football. You have to be able to catch it as well, and he didn't get that done on that play.
So with two ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. Right hash, 37-yard attempt. And the kick for the 41-year-old is up and good. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. It's in the game.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. Both teams have arguably played well enough to be leading at this point, but you see the score and realize this one may very well come down to the wire. All right, let's do this. Here's the first half highlights. Now first and 10. Here the pass would be completed into coverage, and that connection will lead to a gain of 24 yards. Continuing on the drive, Williams is going to get to the quarterback here. This ends up as a loss of 7. Later on the drive, the connection is made in the middle of the field, and he capped off the long drive with the TD. They strike first in the half. Sticking with the same drive, Ingram's going to look for space, and he'll go for the score. Saints is up now by 7. So that'll do it for us at the EA Sports Studio. We're going back under the lights for the second half of this Monday night matchup.
Now here's Bryant to kick it away. Here's LaMichael James to return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. The Falcons set to get things rolling on defense again here. They are down on the scoreboard as we begin the second half and looking to avoid a bigger deficit.
And I can just hear the coaches now. I can hear the head coach. Guys, first 5 minutes, first series of the second half. Offense or defense, you've got to set the tone.
They'll try to set that tone here. And the third quarter starts with a run by Ingram. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
Over the middle, it's Thomas. 12 yards there as they move the chains. And the offense lining up first and 10. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Caught by Snead over the middle. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
And the dreaded face mask penalty, that's going to cost him 15 yards.
And it's such a dangerous play. Body going one way, and then your head gets yanked back the other. 15 yards is the right call.
319! 319!
On first down, he'll drop to throw. He throws, and he hits the slant route to Thomas. And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Simple slant route, and it works to perfection.
And when you're a big-bodied receiver, you use it like it's a basketball play. Body the defender away and catch the football.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Being chased out left. Room here to run. And he'll slide down to avoid the tackle. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
And the next snap coming inside the red zone here.
Four down, four down. Here we go now. Green, 39.
Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for someone to throw to. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
10 yards still left on second down.
Let's go!
They'll look to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. Jonathan Babineau in there to get him. And this pass rush strong now. That sack's on back-to-back plays.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
7 yards on the play, and it'll be fourth down.
Well, partner, nothing comes open here, so he decides to escape out of there, and he doesn't pick up a first down, but he does gain additional yardage to set up a possible field goal attempt if they decide to go that route.
And his kick here is good. And they will stretch their lead to 10 now at 13-3. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point.
Bryant now, after hitting the field goal, gets set to kick this one away. Here's James. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try to increase your lead in a big way. The best way to do it? Touchdowns.
Now let's go. Green 39. Green 39.
One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Saints. They'll be looking to expand their lead here. They've got the football as we start. Shotgun. He'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Brooks Reed in there to get him for his second sack of the night.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
Partner.
One he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
So they're operating in the red zone. It's Mark Ingram, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And they're going to get him down, but not before a pretty good run right there. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1.
I know you're trying to wring every yard out of a run, but I think 9 yards there is ideal in this situation.
Yeah, now next couple plays, you'll only need 1 yard. Keep that clock rolling with a lead here in the fourth.
Yeah, what you're saying is maybe if it takes you 1 or 2 more runs to get the first down, that's extra time, extra plays. Good, hurts the team on defense.
They'll set up a throw. And he almost had it defensively. Could have been a game changer there in this second half. Instead, it's 3rd down.
A missed opportunity for an interception would have killed off a drive. They had a chance there to finish things off. Didn't get it done. I guess that's why a lot of those guys do not play offense.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. They come out here in the eye. A 10th carry here for Mark Ingram. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th and 1.
That was a terrific job by the defense stopping them on third and short. But sometimes you get some visual cues from the offense, because when they're going in short yard situations, you might see the offensive line come in tighter together, a little more shoulder to shoulder, trying to wedge a hole in the middle. They didn't get it done on that play.
So the snap will come from the three, but remember, they don't need the touchdown. They can get the first down if they get a yard and the ball gets to the two. They'll try and sneak it here. Give him 2 yards on that play. And the decision to go for it pays off. They've got a first and goal.
Well, they won't get the touchdown, but they'll get the next best thing as they're able to convert on fourth down, and they'll be left with a first and goal at the 1 yard line.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Looking to run it in, Coon. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
Well, we just saw the recipe for success right there. Big body, strong, agile, playing with great leverage and hands. Not really able to be blocked on that play. Close things down inside.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. It'll buy some time right. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Jonathan Babineau in there to drop him for his second sack now here tonight.
Well, in my time in football, I've yet to see a playbook that draws up offensive plays designed to lose yardage. A running play loses yardage on first down. They try and throw it, take a sack on second down. What can the offensive coordinator come up with here on third down?
After the sack, third and goal now from the 12. Time for a break. We'll come back, see what transpires after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll look to throw on third and goal. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with
the drive starts here with a carry by Ingram. And able to stay on his feet past the 30 to about the 33-yard line. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. To him right up the gut. No. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here, and we'll be back. The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside. The Saints in victory formation now as they'll take the knee. Wonder what's in the offensive. Now a whistle and I think a penalty here for a delay. No, they're going to say timeout. They did get the timeout in time. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Offense working with a third and 13 still left. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Now they'll run it on the toss. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a fourth down. Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk about protecting your home turf. They were able to do that here in this one.
Similar to a tennis match, right? Not letting them break your serve. That way you hold on to it. They got it done, and they feel very good about that victory.
So for the Saints, it's back-to-back victories now after the week one defeat as they move to 2-1. And they will hit the road next week to take on the San Diego Chargers. Meanwhile, for Atlanta, the early struggles continue as they'll sink to 0-3. And they'll be back home next week as they're set to take on the Carolina Panthers. So that's a wrap. For Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. The Saints are winners here as we say so long from New Orleans.